Hey Matterporters, I'm so excited to speak to you about the blur brush today. With the blur brush, you can basically blur out anything you don't want seen in your model. This can be used for a lot of different things, mostly privacy reasons. For example, getting rid of pictures that are up on the walls, information that may be on whiteboards that was captured, car license plates that were captured outdoors, or home addresses and things of that nature. All right, enough of why you might want to use it. Let's go ahead and check this out. The way to get started is by going into settings, and that's right here. And then I'm going to go into manage and just scroll all the way down to the bottom, and you can see the blur brush is right here. It is still in beta, so keep that in mind. Now you just want to make sure that this is active in your account. It may be turned off. Just go ahead and turn it on. And that's really it for enabling this feature. Now let's check out how to use it. So we're in the model page and we go into edit, and you'll see the new blur brush tool is right here. So I'm just gonna click that, and I see the different floors. So depending on what floor I'm at in my model, the blur that I apply will be associated with that floor. And basically I'm just gonna go through here and blur out this image, even though there's no security threat with this one. What I wanna do is press the plus button. And at this point, I just wanna adjust my brush size. So this might be a little bit small for this particular piece. I'll increase it down here. And now I just go ahead and paint as you would with anything else in many other applications. So the more you paint over it, the blurrier it becomes. Once you're done applying the blur to this area, you can go ahead and press the green check mark down here. So that will allow you to keep moving through the model. And it's important to keep in mind that you want to make sure to look around at these areas from every different scan position, because you're gonna have to blur it from each one of those scans that can see this item. So I'm blurring this, and you can see over here, every time I add a new blur item appears, and I'm on the third floor, so they're all associated with the third floor. Let's go ahead and say that I am done with this, even though I do have more scan positions from which I can blur. I'll just go ahead and press the check mark. And you can see now that when I click on blur 3, for example, it'll move me to that scan position and highlight blur 3. Same thing with blur 2. That's blur 2, and blur 1 will zip me back over here. If you're not happy with a blur, you can delete it by using these little three dots up here. You can just hit delete. Or when I click on a blur, it'll take me there, highlight it, and I can press the little trash can icon right down here. So either one, that'll get rid of that. And I can press this, and that will get rid of that one. And I can just go ahead and press the plus symbol, change my brush size, and add a new blur. Once I commit and press this button up here that says apply blurs, it'll ask me if I'm sure that I want to apply the blurs. And if I say yes, it'll take some processing time. I can just go about my business and get out of this model. I don't need to wait for it to finish processing. What it's doing is going in and actually applying those blurs that I've just saved to the actual panels themselves. So be careful currently as the tool is set today. These are destructive, which means you cannot unblur. The only way you're gonna have to unblur this is by reprocessing that model data from capture, and that's gonna create a whole new model. So save yourself that. You can hit no here, and you can apply other changes and things like that and come back to this later if you're not sure. So once I've applied these blurs and they are set in my panos, I do just want to let you know that right now the tool only blurs out the panorama itself. This is the 2D information. So the dollhouse will still have that information. That being said, as you can see, if I go to the dollhouse, things are relatively blurry as it is. For now, the way the tool is today, it's not set to adjust the dollhouse, only the panels themselves. So keep that in mind. And then the other thing is the start location. If you previously had a start location that saw something that you would like to have blurred, and then you went ahead and applied those blurs, the start location still has the information from the previous save. So you're gonna wanna go back to the start location. I'm just gonna go here, and I can click up here on this preview, and it'll take me right to the start location that I already had. And now I'll just press set in order to recapture that start location with whatever I need blurred out in my scene.